Hello, in this last video of the series, I am going to show you how you can work with this extra page of coil and rings to build your own. So I think the easiest thing to do is to just build this on a separate document. Your other choice would be to create another artboard, but let's just go with a separate document. So File, New. It doesn't really matter what size you pick for this, but since we've done everything else on A4, I'm going to select A4 here in the presets, and then I'm just going to bring the DPI down to 144. This is not for print, this is for a digital planner. Screen resolution is 72 DPI, and 144 would give us plenty of room to have it look really good on some of the high-res screens that some of the iPads and stuff have, but yet keep our file size down a little bit by not having too high of a resolution. So I'm going to click Create down here, and that will create a second tab that has another document. So now I can flip back and forth between these two. And that's not really too much of a problem because all I need to do is copy one of these coils and move it over to my new document, and I won't really have to come back here. So I'm going to select this blue ring, and let's just build a simple spiral. So Control C to copy, or you could go up to Edit, Copy, and then I'm going to go to my new document, click on the document, and Control V to paste it. And I'm just going to hold Shift and just drag it out slightly bigger, and Control plus sign just to get in a little bit zoomed in. So now I'm going to have my move tool on, and I can kind of drag it into position. Okay, so now let's build our coils. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this a bunch of times. And the shortcut for duplicate is Control J, or you can go up to the Edit menu and it says Duplicate Selection. So while I've got it selected, I'm going to Control J or Command J on a Mac. And there's one of two things I can do. I can drag this down to wherever I want it. And you'll note that I'm getting some little guides here. That's because I have magnetics turned on here. So you want to make sure that that is darkened. That means it's on. And that will help things stay nice and lined up. The other thing that I can do is I could, I'm going to Control Z to undo that. I could go over to my transform menu and I could pick an amount, and that would kind of help me to stay perfectly vertical as I continue to duplicate down. So we are right now at 29.1. I've got my copy made. It's still selected, and I'm just going to click in this box, and let's just add 10 millimeters to that, so that would be 39.1. Enter. And now if I Control J, it will remember that offset, and I can duplicate a bunch of these rings. And just to kind of be clear, let's just make a copy of this and move it over here, that you can also do that by dragging with the mouse. So I can Control J, and I can just drag this down, let the magnetics guide me, and then still do the same thing. Continue to do Control J. And as long as, when you're doing this duplication, as long as you don't click away or click off the selected duplication, it will continue to remember that offset and perfectly space your coils out. Okay, so let's get rid of these ones and move on. So at this point, you could group your rings together, or you could wait till later. I'm going to wait till later, and let's grab this ellipse tool and let's make a hole punch for this. So holding Shift, I'm going to drag out a circle, and you can just again drag it out, or you can go to this transform window and pick an exact size. So let's just say we want it to be 6x6. Let's fill that with black. Okay, and let's move this over here. So the little red line, because I have magnetics on, is telling me that I'm kind of lined up at the midpoint here, so I know that I'm perfectly lined up with the width of this as well as the width of this. But I don't want it to be in front, obviously. So I'm going to do layer, arrange, and move to back. And so now it is behind. And you'll note that the little shadow on the ring is actually kind of creating a little bit of a punched out crater effect over top of the hole. So that actually works out quite nicely. I don't really feel like I need to do a whole lot more to this hole to make it look realistic. So I can go ahead and select on the hole, and if I have trouble selecting it with the mouse because the objects are too close together, I can always go to my layer menu and just find the ellipse and click on it here and select it. And so now with it selected, I'm going to Control J. And as it happens, we did 10 millimeters in between these. So let's see what happens if we do that again. So I'm going to add 10 to this. And that looks pretty good. So let's just Control J again. So I think that turned out pretty good. I'm just going to kind of test this one, make sure that it's still centered. So I'm going to try and select the back one there. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. So like I said, all the effects that's sort of making it look punched out are actually coming from the ring. So what I can do is I can grab the top one in the layer panel, sorry, and the bottom one while holding shift, and that selects all of them. I can group these, and then I can right click on this, and we'll duplicate this whole group. Now I can take that duplicated group and move it to this side. And I'm just going to put it here and just show you that you can use your arrow keys to just kind of nudge things in slightly. So I think that looks pretty good compared to the other side. So now we have a spiral set of rings. And just to keep things neat, I would grab the top one of these coils, hold shift while I select the bottom one, and Control G to group those as well. And then to really keep things neat, I might just say coils and then double click on this layer, and this is my left holes. Double click on this layer, this is my right holes. So now everything's nice and organized. And you can turn off and on the holes. So if you were, like I showed in a previous video, if you wanted to use this along the inside of your planner, then you would perhaps turn off the holes when you're doing the front cover, when you have the cover over here and you have the holes punched here, but this is just the edges of the ring. All right, so there is a set of coils. So if you wanted to make a set of wire rows, you would do exactly the same thing. And generally speaking, the wire rows have just a single hole punch around the edges. And what I do is I just kind of Google for some images of notebooks and just kind of take a look at what they look like and try and mimic that with these designs. So let's just take a quick look now at creating some binder rings. So these are kind of very simple binder rings. They don't actually have the little tabs at the end to clip them open, but they are, I think they look pretty good for a digital planner. So let's grab the rose one here, and I'm going to use this to create the center of it. And so let's copy it and move that into our new document. And I'm just going to zoom out just a little bit, and I'm going to paste it in here. And so this is going to create actually the middle or the spine of it. So I want to rotate it. I can grab this handle here and I can start turning it. But to get it really precisely rotated over in the transform, there is a rotation here. And you can see right now I'm at minus 92. I'm going to double click this and just make it minus 90. And that will make it perfectly vertical. Now I'm going to scale this out bigger. So let's do something like that. Now, if I wanted to, I could go into the effects here. It's looking kind of flat now. It almost looks like a shiny popsicle stick. So let's go to the 3D and see if we can fix that a little bit. So it under the effects, 3D, and I clicked on the little gear setting here to bring up this expanded menu. So generally speaking, I don't have any particular settings. I just really kind of play with things and see what they look like. I can see that radius did exactly what I wanted to, gave it more of a rounded look. So, you know, you can kind of play with it some more, see what happens when you get a little bit more shine there. Let's go with that. I kind of like that. So, you know, that's where you can change the effects a little bit. And again, I don't have any particular things that I do. I just really play with it until it looks right. So let's go back and grab the binder clip, the clippy parts, the rings, I guess. So Control C to copy it. Let's move that over into here, Control V. And then we will position it. Usually they're not right at the tippy top. They're usually a little bit down. That's about that size. And then I will kind of move it till I get that green line. And again, if you're not seeing those little helper guides pop up, it's probably because you don't have your magnetics or snapping turned on. And I think the same thing with this object. I think we need to give it a little bit more roundness now that it's bigger. So let's see if we can get it looking more round. That looks better. And we'll close that. And now I can copy and paste, or I can duplicate like we did before. I'm going to set my bottom ring down here. And then Control V to paste one more. And we'll just move that over here. Now I can get them evenly spaced by clicking the bottom one, holding shift and selecting all three of these. And then I can go up into the alignment tools and just say that I want to space them vertically. I can also just double check that they're all aligned by picking align left to the selection bounds, and then it's just going to make sure that everything is lined up along this left selection. Okay, so now we have our rings, and we would do the same thing. In fact, we could grab one of these holes and just make it bigger. So let's go back to the layers menu. Now you'll remember we had this grouped. So if we just tried to grab one of these holes, we would get the whole group, and we don't need the whole group. But here's a cute little trick. You can expand the group, just click on one of these ellipses, copy and paste it, and then drag that copy out. And since this is selected, I know that this blue one here is the one that I have. So I can actually drag this out of that group now. And when you're dragging around, try and keep your mouse a little bit to the left. Otherwise, you'd end up nesting under something else. So now I've got my ellipse over here, and I can move it into position. And I can create my hole over here. And so we can play around with the effects of this a little bit if we wanted to make it a little bit more of a shadow. Let's just see what the 3D will do. Again, like I said, I play around with things until they look the way I want. So that's kind of embossing it out. I don't really want that. So let's try the bevel emboss instead. I'm going to turn that effect off, turn bevel emboss off instead. And let's see what happens with the radius here. And if we invert it, There we go. That looks like a hole punch. That's probably a little bit too severe, so let's select it again. And let's see if we can just kind of soften that a little bit so it's not so severe. There, I think that looks pretty good. That gives it a little bit of depth and makes it look like a hole punch. So now I can Control C or Control J if I want to just duplicate, but oops, I need to paste it first. And then I can just move that into position. Control V to paste another one. Move that one down. And then I can grab all three of these, holding a shift while I select all three, copy and paste, and then move them over here. Now my effects are on the wrong side. So let's go back into the bevel emboss, click on the gear to bring up the full menu, and we need to change the direction of that shadow. There we go. So, and I'm not going to actually change it all the way over because the light's generally going to come from one direction. So I'm going to just shift it a little bit, but I'm not going to make it completely reflect. And then we can line that up. And there we go. So now we have built a set of coils and a set of binder rings. You could do all sorts of things with this. I think I mentioned this in a previous video. If you wanted to do like a disc bound style of planner, you could just take this shape, and let's maybe take the blue one, and I would paste it over here. And these disc bound ones usually have, you know, 6 or 8 kind of rings. We could scale it out a bit. And then I would go back to the 3D and make it a little bit rounder. And then we could just duplicate that and just kind of create, I would create 6 of these maybe for a disc bound. And then I would just create the holes on this side because mostly you're gonna see those discs on the outside. And honestly, I haven't taken a look at what a disc bound planner looks like when you open it up. I don't have one myself, so but I would probably take a look at Google Images and see if I could find pictures of open disc bounds and try and replicate that. Okay, so there's a little lesson, a little longer than I had hoped it would be, but a little lesson on building the rings and coils yourself. And in terms of colors, I mentioned this in another video, but all of these can be changed to different colors as well. And what I did with the colors is over on the fill menu, I went to swatches. And if you look in here, you've got a bunch of different Pantone palettes. And so I just went to the metallics one. And so you could switch it to like a golden color. There's some ones that are a little bit more bronze looking or copper looking, and all different sorts of shades and silvers and blues and teals. So lots of pretty metallic colors in there. All right. So I hope you have a lot of fun building with this, and thank you for watching.